Okay, 3, 2, 1. Well, I've been lucky enough to spend exactly one leap year on the space station, 366 days. So you can imagine that in 366 days, you get to see the Earth quite a bit. Even though we are so busy on the space station, we do manage, we do try to look outside and glimpse what's flying below us any chance we get. Was a part of me, the dreamer, the little kid that started dreaming about this whole experience now basically 40 years ago, that part of me was still there, unchanged for 30 or 40 years, and just marveling incredulously at the beauty of it all. And I would see clouds and green and rivers, and it would just completely fill my eyes. The difference in observing the world or the universe from inside the space station, looking through the windows or being outside, is what I describe as the same level of interaction that you can have looking at a beautiful aquarium from the safety of a room. When you're outside and all you have is a helmet and maybe 1.5 inch of plexiglass in front of your eyes, you can see details and colors and shades, the level of detail that you can capture and the way you experience that universe is going to be very, very different. You want and you feel that you have become part of it and you can develop that sense of belonging. I think that the first impact of the first flight was that I did see and I did sense how fragile, how small the Earth is. We are used to think of the Earth as something so vast and big, and we don't think that what we do, our daily life, can affect such a vast system. But from space, you get a sense that Every individual, every living organism is somehow connected. Seeing the city lights at night, where a place like Europe or the United States or Asia, densely populated, everything is so interconnected, and all those lights and all those lives are apparent. They are right in front of you all together, and you think that, you know, all we are doing somehow as an effect on everybody else. You come back from an experience like that thinking that that's what's happening, and then you can see the effects, both the positive ones but mostly the negative ones, in a second flight. And I think you have to acknowledge and grow an awareness, and with that awareness comes the desire to share the experience and share that awareness. It's understanding that the science that's telling us how we are changing and influencing the world has solid mathematical and solid mathematical base. And then you see the effects of it and you just interiorize it. You make it your own experience. And I think that that's what happened. That's why astronauts develop that awareness of and the desire to help the environment somehow, in any way they can.
Subscribe for more space.